Since you haven't slept in 3 nights, allow me to suggest...
What? What is your suggestion? That I should go back to bed? That I should just go back downstairs and climb into bed?
Well, I don't know. Maybe you were planning on sleeping on the roof, but I should tell you, I don't think it's a particularly wise idea.
And why is that? I made this decision, I unplugged the clock, I got out of bed, and I decided to come to the roof. I don't have the energy to make a different decision.
That's ridiculous. That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard.
Well, I can't explain it.
Why not?
I don't know. I just can't.
Try.
Have you ever had insomnia?
Not really.
Well, you do things when it's 2 in the morning. You do things that you wouldn't do at any other time during the day. Because you can't go back to sleep. It is not an option. You know, suppose there's this man breathing next to you, not snoring even, just breathing. But it's loud. And you tell yourself, oh, it's not loud. It's like the ocean roaring. And you can sleep next to that. Then all you want to do is swim into the ocean, and there isn't one. There's just this man next to you, and maybe you had a fight before bed, and maybe you didn't. But there wasn't a wild and passionate anything. You just turned off the lights, and you fell asleep right away. But you gotta get out of there. So you take taxis. Well, at least that's what I do. I climb into a taxi and ride around and get back before my cash runs out.
Taxis?
Well, you asked for an explanation.
But
oh, yeah, the roof, I'm getting there. So the taxi thing is getting expensive, and it was actually my boyfriend who suggested the alternative.
Your boyfriend?
Yeah. You think he hated waking up alone all the time? Maybe he does, but who knows really. Anyway, the taxi thing was getting expensive, and he heard me complaining about it one day, and he said, "What do you want?" I said, "Privacy, my own space, where do you find that?" He said, "I don't know, sometimes I go to the roof." It's a couple months ago he said that, and you know, he's right, it's very,
private?
Yes! Private. Well, the other night it was private. Tonight, we are dealing with tonight.
Are we? What are you doing?
Are you ever scared of heights?
Please.
Trust me, and he'll always be.
crazy getting old. We can talk it so good. We can make it so divine. We can talk it good, how you wish it would be all the time. The drink you spill all over me. Lover spill, that's on repeat. Mom and dad let me stay home. It drives you crazy getting home. You spill all over me. Lover spit left on repeat. Mom and dad let me stay home. It drives me crazy getting home. This dream isn't feeling sweet. Thank you.
makes you so great is that you're different. If you forget an appointment, it's because you're busy working and you don't notice. I wish you might come tonight. The first time I'm frightened. It's been 3 years. I was so young. I didn't matter so much at first. I just thought, well, I'm just going to get a good start and show up. I didn't really mind anything in those days. Not having quite enough food or enough money. I didn't mind because I was so sure that certain part was going to come along. But it hasn't. And what if it doesn't next year? You know, what if it never comes?
Oh.
right back. I just lay in bed for hours, and I was so warm and snug, it was like I had this extra blanket on me. And I don't remember exactly when, but I started feeling hot and cold, and my body felt heavy. I didn't wake up again until the next day. I said, okay, he backed away, but the worst is over. You're still here. But then I had a relapse. I walked around New York as if I were on Mars, and I felt like I had no marrow in my bones. And then I started to read his letters and listen to the songs that he liked, and I can't explain it, but I felt better. I felt great. It was like he hadn't gone at all. He was with me, somewhere on the right, and I could smile at him if I felt like I didn't actually see him right then. But if I leaned against the wall and I pressed my cheek against it, the wall became steep, and the plaster was cool like his skin. And when he went to bed at night, he was with me on his side. The bedding, it becomes his body. And the pillow is his chest, everything can become Steve. My jeans, even the sofa. And I can just fall into the sofa and into his lap. And we're always together now. We laugh and we tell stories of what we've been and what we do. Actually, it's working out perfectly. We're very happy. And we never fight. I don't see why he reaches my feet. He likes the way he used to find me. He likes the girl I left behind me. I
Girls! Girls! Watch out! Watch out! There's a doodling animal running about. It smokes a great big cigar, and it hangs around at a bar. If a terrible thing is my hand, a loud sound. It's a man. It acts just like a crawfish, and the face was whiskered.
She was blonde. I was brunette. She was neat. I was messy. She was thin. I was fat. She was a whore, and I had boobs.
Thank you. he's no good. He will never be able to support you. But when he does have a job, he's going to spend all his money on booze. After a while, there will be other women. There are so many things I meant to tell you but never got around to.
It's nice here. Warm and homey. This used to be the drawing room then. Have I changed much?
Yes. You're much thinner now. Your eyes are bigger. Nina, it's so strange for me to see you. Why wouldn't you let me see you? Why haven't you come sooner? I know you've been here all week. I went to your place and stood under your window like a beggar.
I was afraid that you hated me. I dream every night that you're looking at me and you don't recognize me. Ever since I arrived here, I've been wandering around by the lake. I walked by your house many times, but I never had the courage to come in. Let's sit down. Nice and warm here. Do you hear the wind? There's a passage in Turgenev. He says, it is good for someone on a night like this to have a roof over his head and a warm corner to sit in. Sorry, what was I saying? Yes, Turgenev. He says, and may God help all the homeless wanderers.
It's all right.
No, it's all right, and I feel better. I haven't cried in 2 years. Like last night, I went to look in the garden to see if our theater was still there. And it's still there. I cried there for the first time in 2 years. And I felt a sense of relief. And it felt lighter in my soul.
I loved you. I dreamed about fame. And now? Tomorrow, I take an early train to New York.
What's in New York?
I have a contract there for the winter. I'm a real actress now. I get intoxicated on stage, and I feel beautiful. But now while I'm here, I walk everywhere. I walk, and I think. I think, and I feel that with every passing day, my mental strength grows. Now I know, and I understand, that for our work, it doesn't matter whether it's acting or writing. The important thing is not the fame or the glory. Not what I dreamed about, but the ability to endure. Know how to bear your cross and have faith. I have faith, and it doesn't hurt as much. And when I think about my calling, I'm not afraid of life. It's time to go.
Nina, I hate you. I cursed you. I tore up your letters and photographs, and yet every minute I knew my soul was forever attached to yours. Nina, I can't stop loving you. Ever since you went away, since I started getting published, my life has become unbearable. Please, Nina, stay here with me. Or at the very least, let me come with you. Nina, why? For God's sake, Nina, why?
With a song. Somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one best traveled by, and that has made all the difference.
Thank you.
Archery's recital. Thank you, guys.